snatch it back and hold it, baby, one more time. This is a quick follow-up to the episode on using AmpliTube 5 inside GarageBand. I'll put a card link up to that previous episode. A viewer, Daniel I9252, could get 85 running in GarageBand, but all they saw were sliders for a list of generically named parameters. They figured out the problem on their own, and for anyone else having the problem that doesn't read comments, I wanted to show the solution and what the original problem looks like. I've started GarageBand with an empty project and added an instrument track. As a super fast review, to gain access to the AmpliTube plugin, open the plugins area, and I'm going to replace the amp designer with the amps from AmpliTube. I've done this recently, so it shows up in the recents area, but if you've never done it, just go down to the audio units option at the bottom, select IK Multimedia, and then AmpliTube 5. You should see the AT5 interface we have all grown to love. If you don't, open the GarageBand settings. Let me bring it fully on screen. Make sure you are on the General tab, and check the accessibility area. If you have checked the Open Plugins in Control View by default, your user interface is going to look like a list of parameters with slider knobs. As soon as I uncheck it, the full interface comes back. Thank you, Daniel, for not giving up and tracking down the solution and sharing it.